जय ओम विष्णु पाद परमहंस परिकराचार्य अष्टोरश श्री श्रीमती भक्ति सिद्धांत गोस्वामी महाराज की अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की नामाचार्य श्री हरिदास ठाकुर की प्रेम से बोलो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदादा शिवशति गौर भक्त वृंद की ऑल ग्लोरीज टू द असेंबल डिवोटीज ऑल ग्लोरीज टू द असेंबल डिवोटीज ऑल ग्लोरीज टू द असेंबल डिवोटीज ऑल ग्लोरीज टू श्री गुरु एंड गौरंगा So, we are reading from the Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 10, Chapter 11, Text number 12. Narayanam Namaskrityam Naram Chaiva Narottamam Devim Saraswati Vyasyam Tato Jayamudhirae. Before reciting this Srimad Bhagavatam, which is the very means of conquest, one shall offer respectful obeisance unto the personality of God and Narayan, unto Narayan Rishi, the supermost human being, unto Mother Saraswati, the goddess of learning, and unto Srila Vyasadev, the author. Nastaprayesu Abhadresu Nityam Bhagavat Sevaya Bhagavate Uttam Shloke Bhaktir Bhavati Nashtaki. By regular attendance in classes on the Bhagavatam and by rendering of service to the pure devotees, all that is troublesome to their heart is almost completely destroyed, and loving service unto the personality of Godhead, who is praised with transcendental songs, is established as an irrevocable fact. Saritiragatam Krishnam Bhagnarjunam Atavyat Ramam Charohini Devi Kridadam Balakai Brisham Saritiragatam Krishnam Bhagnarjunam Atavyat Ramam cha Rohini Devi Kridatam Palakai Brisham Saritiragatam Krishnam Bhagnarjunam Atavayat Ramam cha Rohini Devi Kridantam Balakai Brisham. Please recite. Vaishnavis. Sarittiram to the riverside. Gatam, who had gone. Krishnam unto Krishna. Bhagna Arjunam, after the pastime of breaking the Yamuna Arjuna trees. Atha, then. Avayat, called. Raman cha, as well as Balaram. Rohini, the mother of Balaram. Devi, the goddess of fortune. Kridandam, who are engaged in playing. Balake, with many other boys. Brisham, with deep attention. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada ki. Once after the uprooting of the Yamuna Arjuna trees, Rohini Devi went to call Ram and Krishna, who had both gone to the riverside and were playing with the other boys with deep attention. Please repeat. Once after the uprooting of the Yamuna Arjuna trees, Rohini Devi went to call Rama and Krishna, who had both gone to the riverside and were playing with the other boys with deep attention. Purport. Mother Yashoda was more attached to Krishna and Balaram than Rohini Devi was. Although Rohini Devi was the mother of Balaram, Mother Yashoda sent Rohini Devi to call Ram and Krishna from their play, since it was the right time for lunch. Therefore, Rohini Devi went to call them, breaking their engagement in play. I will just read the next verse because it goes hand in hand with the verse of today, and I'll read it alone. Nopayatam yadahuto krida sangena putroko Yashodam presayam asa Rohini putra vatsalam. Because of being too attached to playing with the other boys, Krishna and Balaram did not return upon being called by Rohini. Therefore, Rohini sent Mother Yashoda to call them back, because Mother Yashoda was more affectionate to Krishna and Balaram. Yashodam, so the purport is Yashodam prasayam asa. This very word shows that since Krishna and Balaram did not care to return in response to the order of Rohini, Rohini thought that if Yashoda called, they will have to return, for Yashoda was more affectionate to Krishna and Balaram. Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swamiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesa Sunyavadi Pastatada Satarine Om Gyanam Timirandasya Gyananjana Salakya Chakshun Unmilitam Yena Tasmei Shri Guruve Namaha. Before I start speaking on the Srimad Bhagavatam today, I would like to ask the blessings of all the senior Vaishnavas here, especially all the Prabhupada disciples, that I may be able to speak something beneficial in the science of Krishna consciousness for myself and for all of us who are trying to practice devotional service under the guidance of Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada. Hare Krishna. So, as we can see, initially, Mother Yashoda sent Rohini to go and call Krishna and Balaram, but they did not heed to her. So, Rohini Mataji thought in herself, because she knew that Yashoda Maya was at a higher stage in devotional life, and that Krishna and Balaram will most likely respect her when she called. So she sends Yashoda Maya. You know, this is very common in even in devotee circles, generally we seek the association and guidance of senior Vaishnavas on subject matters, and sometimes we also ask them if they could approach so and so, because it is generally the trend that when someone who is senior approaches someone who is young, in this case, you know, Krishna Balram was just children, or in our cases when someone has just started the practice of devotional life, generally it is much easier with the senior Vaishnava speaking. So that was the trend. As we know that Krishna is just bound by love of his pure devotees, that's the main ingredient. The main ingredient in the loving exchanges between the Lord and his devotee is the aspect or the element of love. And this love is unmotivated, untinged. It is unalloyed. That is what Prabhupada states in his purports, unalloyed devotional service. So it is unalloyed. It is not tinged with any sense of, you know, give and take. Let's put it that way, that I will reciprocate on the basis of this. This is not the basis on which pure devotional life is practiced. It is purely practiced on the basis of unalloyed devotional service, which is pure love. And as we know, during in this chapter, Lord Krishna and Balram display wonderful incidences. And they do these incidents to increase the parental affection of both Nand Maharaj and Yashoda Maiya. So you can see it's a reciprocation. Reciprocation on the parent side and also reciprocation on the Lord side. Because the Lord is playing the role of an ordinary human being. And he actually is doing this, and we'll see as I speak later, Srila Prabhupada mentions that actually it's the will of the Lord by which he is making both Yashoda Maiya and Nand Maharaj so affectionate that on the basis of their affection for little Krishna and Balaram, they cannot even perceive that these are the Supreme Personality of Godhead. You know, if we read all these wonderful feats that have been done by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, we can understand that this is not an ordinary human being. Because how is it possible for him to deliver the two trees and still be bound to the Ulakala motor and nothing happens to him? You know, there are so many incidences. We'll see in this chapter the killing of Bakasur also, the killing of so many demons. We can realize, but in the case of Yashoda Maiya and Nand Maharaj, Prabhupada mentions several times in this chapter that because of their level of affection, they could not comprehend that this was the Supreme Personality of Godhead. In fact, as we know, during the name-giving ceremony, Garga Muni did not indicate directly. However, he did say that if you look at the feet and the astrology of this child, he's as good as Narayan. So Nand Maharaj was aware that Garga Muni had mentioned that my child is as good as Narayan. However, he did not accept, because of that element of affection, that this is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And just like Maharaj was saying the other day, that we know that they are in the birth of Vatsalya, which is parenthood. And we know we have the five rasas. And out of the five rasas, the highest is Madhurya, and then, the highest is Madhurya, and then Vatsalya. So the two prominent rasas between the gopas, gopis, and for Krishna, which is in the Madhurya, and also the Vatsalya ras is what we are seeing. And like Maharaj was mentioning, when we are in this rasa, you want to give something to the Lord, which is very unique, because generally we are asking something from the Lord. or if you're not asking, we are seeking protection from the Lord, or we are seeking for blessings. In any way or form, there is some kind of asking. However, as a parent, which was the position, the exalted position of Mother Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj, they want to give. They don't want to take. So in the mood of giving, they were also not ready to accept. And as I've said, when I was reading all the purports, Prabhupada is just mentioning very strongly on the basis of affection. But again, that affection was so strong that they only wanted to have that relationship, that this is our child, we are going to take care of him. Mother Yashoda had that tendency that if the child is naughty or the child is doing mischief, I'm going to make him a good citizen. So the mood was purely based that this is our ordinary child. And Prabhupada says in his purports that because of this, he bound, that means Lord Krishna bound, just like Lord Krishna binds every living entity in fruitive activities, he binds Mother Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj in parental affection. This is the pastime. So Srila Prabhupada then elaborates on this reciprocation between Nand Maharaj, Yashoda Maya, and Lord Krishna and Balaram, that it was not just that they had the affection, but Lord Krishna desired them to have that parental affection. This was the pastime. This was the lila going on. So it was the desire of the devotee and it was the mercy of the Lord. Both of them were together in that aspect, if you see it, because the Lord desired this, because the devotee desires this. And as we know, the Lord fulfills the desires of his pure devotees. So they wanted to have that reciprocation. So the Lord made sure that reciprocation was taking place. As we know, Srila Prabhupada also has mentioned in the purports that the purest form of love, closest to the transcendental love that we have between us as jivas and the Supreme Personality of Godhead in this world, is exhibited by the love of a mother to a child. It's Prabhupada has mentioned in the purports that this is the closest that we can have a pure definition of love. It's the love between a mother and a child. And that is what we can also see, that the love between Yashoda Maya and Krishna. And Prabhupada then continues to mention, apart from that, that both Mother Yashoda and Rohini could not be separated from Krishna and Balaram even for a moment. They used to pass their time by either taking care of Krishna and Balaram or by chanting about their pastimes. So if they were not physically in their presence, as we know, they used to go and herd the cows in the forests. During those times, they will have the association through remembrance of their pastimes. And what were those pastimes? These are the pastimes that Krishna is enacting in Vrajabhumi, the killing of the demons, you know, the reciprocation with the parents, you know, and all the activities he's doing with the gopas and gopis. So they were absorbed in the thoughts and pastimes of Krishna. So if they were not personally seeing them, they were absorbed in the thoughts. And that brings us to our stage of devotional life. We are not at the stage that we are serving the Lord directly in that way, but we are serving the Lord through the deity form in the temple. So that is why engagement or service in devotional life is very important, because like Prabhupada says, 100%, Prabhupada says in the purport, 100%, he doesn't even say 100%, he says 100% our consciousness should be fixed in devotional life. And towards this, obviously, last time I was requested to repeat this because Maharaj was giving us the five essences. You know, we have 64 items of devotional service that are mentioned in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu by Srila Rupa Goswami, out of which the last five are the most prominent. And last time, when I asked the question, Maharaj gave all the answers. However, Maharaj did not have a mic, so some devotees told me what were those five. So for the sake and benefit of the devotees asking me, I'm going to mention those five because they are actually in line with what we are trying to speak today on devotional service. So Prabhupada mentions that when we are engaged in devotional service, all the activities of the mind, body and senses are engaged. So all the senses pertaining to the mind, body and the senses are engaged in the service of devotional service. So the five items, does anyone know one of them or all five? Maharaj, if you don't have mic, then they'll make me repeat it. So what I'll do is I will repeat each that you say, because that was... So the first one, Maharaj? Perfect. So one is chanting the holy name of the Lord. And this is one of the most essential things that the founder Acharya of ISKCON has instructed us. Obviously, we know the history of this, that Prabhupada started with 64. The devotees came and said, oh, Prabhupada, this is too much. Then Prabhupada said 32. And then still the devotees came back and said, Prabhupada, this is too much. And then Prabhupada said, finally 16. And no? No less, no more. At least 16 rounds have to be done. So, as we can see, Rupa Goswami's instructions on the five most important things is chanting. One is chanting of the holy names. And so that is why our founder Acharya was very particular about this. So chanting. And if we read Srila Prabhupada's purports, Srila Prabhupada says very clearly, in fact in this very chapter, Prabhupada says that if you're not really relishing the malice of transcendental love, then you're doing offenses in your chanting. There is offenses associated that is making you not relish that transcendental love, as we can see is being relished by Yashoda Maya and Rohini. So one of them was chanting. Does anyone know one more? It's again Maharaj. Yes sir. Association with devotees. Exactly. Association shall associate with devotees is the second item out of the five that is mentioned by Srila Rupa Goswami, is associating with devotees. And associating with devotees is key, as we all know. I don't need to elaborate on that. But out of that, just as a very important note, we have three levels of devotees. So we should understand that we have the Kanishtha Adhikaris, or neophyte stage. We should know that there's the Madhyam Adhikari, the middle stage, and we have the Uttam Adhikaris, or the advanced stage. So we should take instructions from the Uttam Adhikaris. We should associate with Madhyam Adhikaris, same peers, and we should give association to the Kanishtha Adhikaris. This is very important, because even association, Rupa Goswami has given us the distinction of the three classes of devotees. If you take association with neophytes, you're not really gonna progress. If anything, you may become more bewildered. And as we know, Maya is there to bewilder us at every moment. And Maya is very strong. Because Maya is also a potency of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. It's the external potency. So, the association should also be considered in elements of who are you associating with. Which is the third one? Yes. And what do we mean by residing in a holy place? Does it mean, like Prabhupada has very clearly mentioned this, it doesn't mean staying in Vrindavan or Jagannath Puri. In fact, Archita Prabhu also cleared this for me. It is residing like we are in Rukmini Dwarkadesh. This is a holy place. So we are again coming to the five important things of devotional service. And we as devotees should see, are we in these five? We are residing at Rukmini Dwarkadesh. You are residing in a holy place. We are very fortunate. If you want to know how fortunate you are, just ask Naikatma Prabhu. He has a wait list of 30 plus who want to move into the temple community. literally I have as the congregational outreach person, a Prabhu can testify how many people are begging. In fact, one person was waiting for 2 hours for Swawas Prabhu while Swawas Prabhu was in the memorial, just waiting to see if he can speak to him about getting into the community. To that, I will give you an analogy. You know, sometimes we have something and we do not know the value of it because we have it. We take it for granted. We are staying at a holy dam. If you have any ifs and buts as to this is not a holy dam, then you need to really come and see the senior Vaishnavas. Because holy dam doesn't mean Mathura, Vrindavan. Holy dam means where the Lord is being worshipped. And we are worshipping Rukmini Dwarkadesh. In fact, a lot of devotees in the congregation ask me this question, that how come almost all ISKCON temples, it is Radha Govind, Radha Gopinath, Radha Vallabh, Radha Madhav. Why is it that we call the deities here Rukmini Dwarkadesh? And correct me if I'm wrong, you know, I will ask. I tell them because Prabhupada wanted the service of this temple to be opulent, that the lords are served in an opulent mood. Am I correct, Swawas Prabhu? So opulence. So that opulence, you can see the deity service standards here are very high. In fact, Maninath Prabhu was just at the seminar and he told me himself that everyone looks at Rukmini Dwarkadesh as the benchmark of service. So we are residing at a holy dam. Now the question is, we have spoken about three. So we are residing, we are chanting, we are associating. What are the other two? Exactly. Here in Srimad Bhagavatam, which is what we are doing. Here in Srimad Bhagavatam. Because when we are hearing the science of Krishna consciousness, it makes us firm. It makes us resolute. Because it gives us the basis of why we are doing this. Srila Prabhupada never told us to follow anything blindly. He never gave us anything that we will not accept. That's why he put open questions. A lot of people are frightened to even ask questions because they don't know what will be thrown at them. And as we know, Srila Prabhupada always spoke in tattva. He spoke on the basis of authority. Why? Because he himself knew the scriptures. Sadhu, Shastra, Guru. Which is the fifth one? Yes, Maharaj. So the fifth one is worship of the deity. That's why I was emphasizing on the point of deity, how important our standards of deity worship here are. So we are chanting, we are listening to Srimad Bhagavatam class, we are associating with devotees, and we are very senior Vaishnavas here. We are residing at Rukmini Dwarkadesh, and on top of that, we have the opportunity to serve the deities. Now, serving the deities, worshipping the deities, is service that can be rendered towards the deities. Doesn't, correct me if I'm wrong, Archita Prabhu or senior Vaishnava, it doesn't mean being a pujari. It means anything that you can do that is used for even spreading the name of Krishna, the glories of Krishna. Am I correct, Prabhu? So engagement, in essence, it means engagement. And that is devotional life. So why is this so important to us? Because we can see that the Lord is only bound by the pure love of his devotees. There is nothing else that can bind the Lord. And that's why we actually say in the Srimad Bhagavatam, it's very clear, Savai Pumsham Paro Dharmo Yato Bhakta Adok Saje, that the highest goal of religion is devotional life. And in the most confidential knowledge on in Bhagavad Gita, we have Raja Vidyam, Raja Guyam, Pavitram Idam Uttamam, Parakshakshavagamam Dharmyam Susukam Kartum Avyayam. What does this knowledge entail? This knowledge is the king of education. The most secret of all secrets. It is the purest knowledge. And because it gives direct perception of the self by realization, it is the perfection of religion. It is everlasting and it is joyfully performed. Srila Prabhupada comments on the purport. If you read the Raja Vidyam, Raja Guyam purport, it's I think about 4 or 5 pages purport. And Srila Prabhupada comments in his purport that it is that the soul is eternally active and its activities in the spiritual kingdom are the most confidential part of that spiritual knowledge. So this Raja Vidyam, Raja Guyam is actually understanding the activities of the soul in the spiritual kingdom. That is the confidential knowledge, Raja Vidyam, Raja Guyam. And Prabhupada also continues, Srila Prabhupada continues to mention that the purifying potency of devotional service is very strong and it is called Pavitram Uttamam, the purest. Uttamam means transcendental. And Prabhupada emphasizes that this devotional service is carried out here and is eternally being carried out in the spiritual world. Not like what the Mayavad school thinks, that I will do it here and then I will merge into the body of the Supreme Personality or into his effulgence and again it stops. No, it is eternally going on. Why? Because the soul is eternal. And because the soul is eternal, there must be an occupational duty of something that is eternal. And that occupational duty of the soul is the most confidential part of the knowledge, and that is devotional service. And towards that, then we are going to speak on Rupa Goswami's 6 divisions of surrender. Again, so we are going to speak, we saw the 5 essential things. Now let's look at what are the 6 divisions of surrender. Because there must be some surrender. If there is no surrender, then we cannot practice devotional service. So what are the 6 divisions of surrender that Srila Rupa Goswami gives us? Yes, Maharaj. Yes, Maharaj. Exactly. So let me elaborate on those 2 and then we can... So Maharaj is right. Accept everything that is favorable for devotional service. And we know what is favorable. You know. So favorable to devotional service and reject things that are unfavorable. Association with devotees is favorable. What are you rejecting? Rejecting associating with people who are not on the platform or who are not practicing bhakti yoga. So anything that is not favorable towards devotional service should be rejected. And anything that is favorable should be accepted. So those are 2. Which is the 3rd one? Does anyone apart from Maharaj know the 3rd one? Archita Prabhu, you can please also elaborate. You know? Yes. You know, again, this is very important because we need to know the basic things about devotional life. Because if we do not know, you know, when the nectar of devotion was produced, Srila Prabhupada called it the law book of ISKCON. And in our Bhakti Shastri course, it is one of the scriptures that we have to read. So it is very important for us to know what our acharyas, Rupa Goswami and all, are mentioning to us, because this is for the cultivation of our spiritual life. So we know that we have to accept, we have to reject. Does anyone know the other 4 or anyone? Oh yes, okay. Yes, 4. Yes. Becoming very meek and humble. Depend on the mercy of the Lord. So let us speak on being meek and humble. That is a very important guna. It's one of the characteristics of a Vaishnava. And as we know, in the Shikshastakam prayers, Trinad api sunichena taror api saisnuna. Amanina manadena kirtanya sadari. Trinad api sunichena. In a very humble state of mind, we should chant the name of the Lord. So we have to imbibe that mood of meekness and humbleness. So then, like Maharaj mentioned, a devotee should accept Krishna as his supreme maintainer and master. And believe that Krishna will give him protection. And Prabhupada states very clearly, in his translation that devotee must be firmly convinced of this fact that this that Lord Krishna will give protection. Must be firmly convinced of this. If we are firmly convinced that the Supreme Personality of Godhead will maintain us, is our master, we should firmly believe in those words. And the last one is self-surrender. Remembering that one's activities and desires are not independent of the Lord. So there must be that surrender aspect. Again, surrender has been mentioned by Srila Prabhupada. So, this is key because now we are also looking at the divisions of surrender. We are remembering the importance of devotional service. What are the things that enable us to practice devotional service? And then on top of that, then Srila Prabhupada mentions very clearly that we have to be very careful of our offenses, especially towards the Vaishnavas, because that is what will check us in our devotional life. So we want to be very careful of Nama Aparad, and we want to be very careful of Vaishnava Aparad. So these two aparads we have to be very, very careful, because they are impediments, they are the weeds in our devotional life. And as we know, there is a very important shloka in Chaitanya Charitamrita, which actually is very powerful, because it tells us the power of chanting the name of the Lord. And it is Nama Sankirtan Haitas Sarvanartanasa Sarva Subodaya Krishna Primara Ulasa. Simply by chanting the holy name of Lord Krishna, one can be freed from all undesirable habits. This is the means of awakening all good fortune and initiating the flow of waves of love for Krishna. So, again, we are reciprocating with the Lord through the chanting process. And the love for Krishna, the dormant, is reawakened by the process of chanting. And if we read the most confidential knowledge in Bhagavad Gita, there are so many shlokas, so much emphasis on why this is the most confidential knowledge, why this is so important that we practice this devotional life, we live it. You know, Srila Prabhupada actually lived it, because Srila Prabhupada also mentions that bhakti yoga is the purification of the senses. So through the process of bhakti yoga, we are also purifying the senses. And we have to live it every moment. And to live it every moment, one of the most important things that I came to read is what Prabhupada is saying, that the best process of advancing in devotional service is to abide by the orders of the spiritual master. So the best process of advancing in devotional service is to abide by the orders of the spiritual master. And then Srila Prabhupada says, because we sing this every morning, Yasya Prasado Bhagwat Prasado. In our morning prayers, we say Yasya Prasado Bhagwat Prasado, which means by the mercy of the spiritual master, a devotee conquers the influences of both Raja, Tamo, and Sattvic Gunas. Yasya Prasado Bhagwat Prasado, and becomes situated on the transcendental platform. So by the mercy of Guru Kripa Bhai Bhakti Lata Bij, by the mercy of Guru, we are able to advance in devotional service. So the process of advancing in devotional service is following the orders of the spiritual master. And then Srila Prabhupada very clearly mentions, what does it mean by following the orders of the spiritual master and becoming fixed? Is obviously taking instructions from the spiritual master, is determined, and is determined how? Because the senses have been controlled, because the senses have been engaged in the transcendental service of the Lord. And is fixed because of determination and knowledge. We are determined and we have knowledge. And that knowledge is coming even by attending Srimad Bhagavatam class, Bhagavad Gita class, by listening to Srila Prabhupada's lectures. We have a lot of lectures also by senior Vaishnavas in the movement, associating with them. So all this is solidify our Krishna consciousness. So the essence of why I'm speaking on this is because that is the only way to bind the Lord through pure unalloyed devotional service. So it is very imperative for us to practice this very seriously and know how to advance. It is now time, so I will end here. And if there is any more elaborations by senior Vaishnavas, any questions? Yes, Archita Prabhu. Okay. Unfortunately, I didn't write this verse, which is wrong, but I will give you I know you know the verse number. But yes, that is very important. Nam Sankirtana Haites Savanartha Nasa Sarva Sobodaya Krishna Premara Ullasa. So just by the chanting of the holy name, we get great fortune. And it is joyfully performed. You know, it is so important. It's just two lines, but it is so sweet. Because if, you know, like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, if you know my hairs do not stand up by chanting or reciting of your holy name, then something is not working right. And Prabhupada said that the biggest thing is offenses. Offenses is checking us. Hare Krishna.